as promised, Bill Comins.
I brought the two pickup guitar,
and I brought a one pickup. And I'm going to grab the one pickup now. It was two pickup, obviously. I don't know what you guys can hear on the internet, but I just thought I'd try to do a little demonstration of the difference of the two, and I'll talk about a little bit what I hear afterwards. But anyway, it'll be on the video. You can maybe put on some headphones and see what you can discern. But I don't know what you'll hear. So anyway,
I got questions for you, Bill, when you're done. When you're getting the one pickup.
Yeah. This is the violin burst color. People ask me, what's the difference between the one and the two? I'll tell you what I hear. I like a one pickup guitar because you hear an expanded range, more of the overtones, and it's really nice when you're playing solo or in a small trio. There's a liveliness to the acousticness, even on a laminate guitar such as this. The two pickup version, I also like. And if I was playing in a louder situation, a bigger ensemble, I always feel like there's a compression that happens with the two pickup guitar by putting that mass right in front of the bridge. Electrically, it's a little bit more even all across the range. And if I'm playing in a louder situation, or I want to play more lyrically, I have a preference for the two pickup. So I'm glad I'm doing both models. I wasn't sure which way to go, but they're different guitars. So if you are kind of a living room player or you play in a small ensemble, you like the acousticness of the guitars, the one pickup's the way to go. If perhaps you've already got a guitar like that and you're looking for something that's really going to excel on a bandstand, the two pickup one is just a nice option. So people ask me which I like better. I don't really have a preference. Everyone gravitates toward the aesthetic of the one pickup. They think, well, I never use this pickup. That's all. I never use the bridge pickup. That's all I need. There's something about the sound of the guitar. We talked about like the Gibson CES guitars, mm-hmm. right? That's the iconic jazz guitar sound, the two pickups in the top. It is a lot quieter acoustically, but electrically, it's a little more substantial. So I just want people to know the difference. Maybe if you go back, you can hear the difference. You know, I didn't play a lot there, but maybe you'll hear something. Anyway, so that's the point.
Right. Here's a question from Bing Bob. I know Bing Bob from, I'm not using people's real names, except maybe this guy's name really is Bing Bob. Anyway, okay. How much is the blonde Comins and where is it made? If it is made overseas, is it sent to Bill Comins for final setup or is it ready to go from the overseas factory? More. Regarding the GCS1, what exactly does this mean? The sides, internal box structure, are routed from a solid wood core?
Okay, all right. This line of instruments, the Comins Guitar Craft series, I think a lot of people are hip to this, but I've been making high-end guitars for 25 plus years. I kind of wanted people to understand that there was a difference between that, those guitars sell for either side of 10K for an arch top, and this production line of instruments I do. I wanted to make something that could speak to players who maybe not have, you know, that kind of money to spend on a guitar. I wanted something that was player ready, bandstand ready, something that was set up really well. So yes, they're made for me in South Korea. These are great people. I'm grateful they're doing business with me. I've given them my design. I've selected the components. They do a nice job on the guitar. It comes to me for quality control. You know, there are a number of things I do in the shop when they get to me. And first and foremost is a complete setup. So all the frets get dressed, the nut gets worked on. The setup, I spent a lot of time with the setup of these. I have a little help in the shop, but every one of these is seeing these hands, at least for the time being. That to me is the most important thing, because if they don't play right, they're never going to sound right. So yes, made for me in South Korea. What were some of these questions? GCS, Guitar Craft Series. That's what GCS. Yes.
Okay. Another one. One more question for Bill. You demoed a hybrid jazz guitar. It was a cross between a flat top and an arch top. It was the Zelig model. It sounded fantastic. I want one. How much? Do you know what he's talking about?
Yeah,
he's that the one I had.
The one you demoed.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah, that was a fun guitar. It was, so far it's a one-off. I've got a couple other things in the works that are, it's just some ideas I have that are evolving. I mean, that would be a whole other video. It's the Zelig model. It was a hybrid between a flat top and an arch top. I think it was successful in a lot of ways, and price-wise, email me. I don't know. Right now, because of these, my customers for my hand-built stuff have been waiting maybe a little too long, and I'm trying to get back on that. So the wait time is kind of pushed back a little. It's at least a couple of years.
You're going to like this one. Guy named Steve. Bill, are you hiring?
Short answer is no. But, you know, maybe down the road, you know, send me an email. I'll put it on file.
Okay. I'm digging the Comins guitar line, especially his semi-hollow. Plan to get one ASAP. I'll ask if he offers one with a D-neck.
Yeah, so again, these being production guitars, I can't offer custom features. That's the way to keep the price where it is. You know, they vary somewhat, so, you know, you might find one that's slightly different than the other, but overall, they're pretty consistent. D-neck, you know, the spec is actually for a C, but they kind of come somewhere across between a C and a D. I'd say just put one in your hands and see what it feels like to you.
Okay. Here we go. Question for Bill. I have heard only glowing positive reports on his new arch tops and his other guitars, particularly the finish, fretwork, necks, etc., are all said to be fantastic. My question is, how does he achieve this study? Does he get guitars back from the people who make them and have to send some back that do not meet his standards or are the standards of?
Okay. Yeah, well, you know, I couldn't do business with these people if they didn't know what they were doing. They've been in this business for a long time, and a long time. And things are pretty consistent. It's not to say that there isn't an occasional thing that I have a problem with, whatever. And occasionally, some of these have ended up in the spray room, perhaps for a little touch-up here and there. But for the most part, they come pretty good. I don't send them out if they're not right. So yes, I've had a couple of seconds. I've had a couple that, you know, whatever, I own one. But
there's another one. How much work is done on a guitar once it arrives in the States before being sold? Is fretwork done here or before the guitar is sent here?
I think I covered that. I mean, these probably see 4 hours of bench time in my shop. So that these get a workout.
For the past 10 years, I've exclusively played on an Eastman 805CE archtop guitar, and I'm starting to wonder if it's time to start putting money aside for an upgrade. What are some of the biggest differences between Eastman or other guitars in this $2,000 to $3,000 price range?
Yeah, I don't really pay attention to any of that. You know, I've played some Eastmans. I don't really even like commenting about other companies. And, you know, it's an okay guitar. I don't know what to say, really.
Yeah. Here's a good question. Where can you go to test play some of Comins' archtop guitars in Philadelphia area?
Okay, Latanzi Guitars is one of my dealers in the King of Prussia area. So I'd say that's pretty darn close to Philadelphia.
Yeah. Bill has a shop in the Philly area with a question mark.
That's it. I'm there sometimes. Anthony's got a shop. Anthony Latanzi Guitars. He's an up and coming guitar maker. So keep an eye on him. he's a dealer of the GCS guitars, Guitar Craft Series guitars, and some days I'm there. So he only takes people by appointment, so you need to set that up ahead of time. But that is a place you can see the GCS guitars.
Yeah, that's a good one. Question for Bill. Love the GCS-1 shape. Any plans for a carved top, thin arch top version?
A carved top, thin arch top.
Of GCS-1. Is that that one?
Yeah, that's it. These are laminates. Carved tops, you'd have to talk to me about whether I'd build you one. But the guitars are laminates, if that's the question. And again, nothing's custom here. This is just the design.
GCS-16 is a hollow body arch top jazz box. Will we see a true solid body Comins guitar?
I talk a lot about where the next this arch top has been a long time coming, and I'm glad it's finally seeing the light of day. And there's talk of what the next model will be. Solid bodies have come up. I'd say that's a market that's pretty well served. And I can't say that's necessarily going to happen or not, but I appreciate the interest. And if you guys have ideas, shoot me an email.
This is from a guy named Dan. What do you love best about luthiery? Do you have to be a competent guitarist to be a competent luthier?
Well, there's a lot of luthiers who are not players who make beautiful guitars. I've always found, though, that it kind of centers me in my building and guides me, because to me these are musical instruments more than anything. They're not, I'm not really interested in guitars as pieces of furniture. So I get around a little bit on a guitar, and I think it's always helped me decide, how to build, what to build. Yeah, I think it's helpful.
I would like to ask you about the upcoming Artesian, guitar show in April in Harrisburg. What is he bringing to the show, and about the custom archtop guitar market has changed across his 25 years as a luthier?
Well, I will be going to the show. It's in April, I believe. They've arranged for a door prize for one of these two pickup models. So if you guys want to go, I think you have to be there on Sunday for the drawing. I don't know. Anyway, I'll be going. I'll have some of my high-end guitars as well as some of these. I don't know what exactly yet. I'm a little behind schedule with my high-end builds because of this, but I'm trying to get back on track. But I'll have some high-end stuff there either way. And what was that?
Any other part of that?
You're blowing through these questions too quick, man. I'm not getting to the whole thing.
How has the custom archtop guitar market has changed across this 25 years?
Wow, that's a big question. I could talk for hours on that, but I'll say that, there seems to be more interest in the 16-inch size than there was when I started. It was more about 17 the standard. Yeah, that's the biggest thing. I mean, there are other things, but for another day.
In terms of sales, is the GCS model as successful as you hoped it would be?
Yeah, I can only do so many. We're a small operation, and I've moved maybe in the 400s of these guitars, and I don't advertise and don't really go to shows. It's just a word of mouth. I mean, all you guys on the internet is what's made these things catch on. So I'm happy enough for now, and I'd like to continue to try to grow it.
Yeah, maybe you could show them the
GCS one.
Yeah, I call it the solid body.
Yeah, it's not really a solid body.
And I'm using this a lot on the CD that I'm gonna make with Craig Thomas. Me and Craig Thomas. Some of it is me playing with me, which I seem to do a lot of lately.
So this is the GCS. The GCS 1ES is what Jimmy has. It has a spruce top. Can't see it under the black finish. But spruce top and ebony fingerboard. There's also a version with a maple top and a rosewood board. This one's a little more jazz tone specific. It's a little kind of a tighter, cotton mouthy, thicker sound because of the ebony board and spruce top.
The other one's a little bit more, maybe a little more versatile, more open and clear sounding. You can get rock tones maybe a little easier on the Mabletop version. Some people prefer that clear sound for the jazz, for jazz sounds. And I've been doing this since 2012 or 13, and it's been going really well. It's this one's I think the street price is $14.99, and most people tell me it's a lot of guitar for the money. Same factory, same idea. It's my design. They make over there. I work on the pickups with Kent. We kind of get the windings and so forth right. come to my shop for the full setup. And they're when I have them in stock, they go out the door.
Chris, if you got more questions, you can post them underneath this video. That you can't post them too many places because I won't get them because there's too many places to go. Even though the fact I really don't have a life except for playing a guitar and going to see doctors, All right, so
you sounded good though, right? You sounded great every day.
Yeah, I enjoy. I like to play them. All right, gang. So I'll talk to you soon. Bye.